We've officially completed one day of no processed foods. I don't know if we were necessarily the most prepared, but I'm feeling much better entering day two, being a bit more prepared. I'm making bread from scratch. Well, I kind of cheated. I made the dough last night, but the light was crap and...
lighting is everything.
You said it best. Okay, so come join me as we bake this big old baby. Okay, here's the dough. She rose last night. You could tell she kind of fell a little bit, but it's okay. She's a little overproofed. I found that epic organic whole grain, American grown wheat. I guess we could go a month with no bread. I feel like there's a way to do it in a very wholesome, connected way. So that's what we're trying. So this is my whole wheat sourdough dough. Filled with hemp seeds, and we're gonna cover her with some sesame seeds. Okay, she's gonna hang in the fridge while we preheat the oven. And you're not gonna believe this, but we literally found this epic cast iron enamel in the dumpster at the beach. The thing about me is I have no patience, so I'm not gonna toast it. I'm just gonna take a bite.
And I have patience.
Whole wheat sourdough. It's pretty good. A little avo toast. We got homemade sourdough, avocado, tomato, onion. Brooks is sprouts. And a little fruit and green smoothie.
Very good.
I had an insight. I almost like tossed one of the little nubs of the bread into the compost when I was cutting it up. And I was like, oh no, you can't let that good bread go to waste. And I feel like when you're super connected to your food, especially if you make it yourself, you don't want it to go to waste because you understand the care and the time and the effort it takes to make it. So maybe by slowing down the food system, we would inherently waste less of it too. Food for thought.
You know, we've been together a long time. And I think any couple who can remain calm and peaceful when they're hangry, they've got something special.
Hour six, and we're throwing in the towel.
And we're starving.
And we're starving.
And we're realizing that we can't get what we would normally get at Chipotle.
Okay, here's the question.
Wow.
Why was this the same price as if we got a chicken and steak bowl?
$9.15.
I think the other one's like $9.40 or something.
Hmm.
That ain't add up. We got less shit.
Physiologically speaking, how are you feeling?
I feel good. Energy levels are good. I will say something I've noticed is I'm pooping a lot. Like 4x what I was typically pooping.
4x.
Yeah, so it's a lot of beans.
Beans and fruit. The magical fruit.
So yeah, lots of shit.
If I was a kitchen appliance, I would 1000% be my Instapot. I know some of you are gonna come at me for not soaking my beans, and you totally can. Just put them in the Instapot for a little longer. It's about 3 cups of beans. This is my secret ingredient. Kinda looks like pea, but it's homemade veggie broth, and we make it from our veggie scraps. And I swear it just tastes like love. Look at that color. Well, it's like a little peace sign. Okay, doesn't look like anything crazy now, but let me tell you, this is about to be delicious. 26, sure. Turn off the keep warm. And I will see you then, or I'll see you at another time. It's definitely living up to its name of being a challenge. Speaking of challenges, Brooks, where are you going this week?
Climbing a mountain.
Big one.
Big mountain, Mount Whitney, with some friends, yeah. Which, didn't think about this when we started this challenge.
Yeah.
Typically, like, backpacking and hiking, you've got the, like, MREs, the dehydrated meals, you've got the Cliff Bars, you've got the goos, you've got the hydration, you've got, like, a whole world of super processed products. We're going to try to do it without it. Trying to.
As best we can.
So I'm going to show you how I'm going to turn all of these whole foods into backpacking camping foods. Let's get it. I'm kind of just winging this, to be honest. Lauren usually is the one with the recipes and the skills. And a little spice. About y'all, but that looks unbelievable to me. I think everybody at the campsite's gonna be jealous.
Not gonna lie, it's our first time using the dehydrator. My mom is a queen at it. I, however, am still a beginner. So we have these trays and it needs to go in there for 8 hours, which means it's gonna cook until like 10 p.m. the night before he leaves, which sounds like a great idea. True life, we have a small house. And this is where the dehydrator goes. Timer 10, I'll just keep it on 10 hours and we can take them out early if we need.
Sounds good.
Ooh, these are good dates. Okay, we start by blending the dates.
That is a good scoop if I've ever seen one.
Having a power bar, this is what he'll eat on the trail.
So I would usually bring some sort of hydration with me on the hike. There's 12 different ingredients and there is 48 grams of sugar in this. So we're not gonna bring this and we're gonna make our own natural hydration. So it turns out all hydration is natural sugar and sodium. And you put that together, that's what keeps you hydrated.
Himalayan salt.
Okay, now we need 4 cups of water.
Wait, Brooks. I dare you to take a shot of that. I don't even think we have a shot glass. Ocean, do you want to drink that on your hike?
Really good.
Is it actually?
I love sour stuff, so that's super good.
It's not too salty?
Get some chips so bad.
What a beautiful day.
Oh, this is spectacular.
We're
having positive attitudes.
We got hail coming down. It's literally hailing right now.
So that was gnarly. We're gonna try and make dinner now. For an appetizer, we have lentil bread. Wow.
That was pretty good.
So here's my thought. I'm gonna tell Lauren it tastes great, regardless of how it tastes. I mean, that's amazing. That's really, really, really good. Wow. There's something about being in this like, just untouched, beautiful nature that you're like, why would we all not like be protecting this and trying to save it and conserve it for, you know, the future and others who haven't seen it? It feels so small in comparison to like the vastness of the earth.
We're having fun now. We're having fun.
We are so humbled at how much work this takes. It feels like Brooks and I are cooking and cleaning all day. And cleaning and cleaning and cleaning. If we threw kids or a job with a commute into the mix, this would be extremely difficult, if not impossible. If we didn't have all the fancy gadgets we've borrowed from friends and family, it would take even longer. The current US systems prey on the individual. If we're overworked, we have very little time and therefore need something convenient. And if we're underpaid, we need something cheap. And what does cheap and convenient food look like? A whole lot of this. And what happens when folks eat a lot of these ultra-processed foods? They get sick. How can these engineered foods that have been proven to cause diseases still be allowed to be sold on shelves while food companies flip profit? It all seems so backwards. As with the majority of national and global problems, it can feel overwhelming as to what one person can do. But we believe that it starts with awareness, and this challenge is helping us do just that. We don't have all the answers, we're learning more each day, and we have found these resources to be extremely helpful. They're listed in the description for you as well. Thank you so much for watching. We'll be back next week as we hit the halfway point on our month-long challenge, so make sure to subscribe.
Wanna make a snack if you want something?
Did you fart?